Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and I'm starting a new video series on Docker networking. In this video, we are discussing the simplest type of the Docker networking, that is single host bridge network. In this type of network, all containers can communicate with each other that are on the same host. When you installed Docker on Linux machine, then Docker network build on Linux network fundamentals or technology. That's include Linux bridge, network namespace, virtual Ethernet device, IP tables. So let's look at these Linux network components or fundamentals one by one before jump on Docker networking. So first component is Linux bridge. A Linux bridge is layer 2 device in OSI model, that is the virtual implementation of physical switch. It forward traffic based on MAC address on the same host. Docker network or Docker bridge is implemented or based on Linux bridge. Let me bring couple of diagram. This is a diagram of the physical switch. Three devices, physical server, storage and printer, are connected to the physical switches via physical port. So that is your physical switch. This particular diagram talks about how does VMware or any other virtualization tool create virtual switches by using kernel bridge. A physical machine or physical host is connected with physical network interface card to physical switches. A VMware tool, for example, is hosted on this physical machine and it creates a virtual switches with virtual network interface card. When you create a new VM in VMware, then a virtual network interface card attach and link to virtual switches so that these VM can communicate with each other and outside world. The same concept applicable with any virtualization tools like VMware, VirtualBox, Hypervisor, or even it is applicable for the Docker. This particular diagram demonstrates a Docker network on a VM. A Docker network use Linux bridge technology or fundamentals to create virtual switches and attach virtual Ethernet card to the containers. Next one is network namespace. A Linux network namespace is an isolated network location in the kernel that has its own interfaces, routes and firewall rules. Network namespace ensures that two containers on the same host aren't able to communicate with each other or even the host itself until unless a bridge created between them via Docker network. This is a diagram for the network namespace and you can see here the Docker network create separate namespace for each container in the Docker network. If there is no bridge defined by the Docker network, these containers can't communication with each other or the host. So this is your network namespace components. Okay. Next one is virtual Ethernet devices. You can understand virtual Ethernet devices like a wire between two namespaces. When a container is attached to a Docker network, then one end of the VAT is placed or stored inside the container, while other is attached to the Docker network. This is the example of virtual Ethernet devices. This is your virtual Ethernet device or VAT. One side of this, it is connecting to Ethernet 0 inside container 1, and other side it is connecting to Docker's network. Next one is IP tables. Docker network utilize IP table to segment network traffic, provide host port mapping, and mark traffic for the load balancing decision. Now time is for the practical demonstration. I am using the CentOS 7 for this demonstration. Installed these package to complete this exercise. List down the existing IP address along with virtual network interface card information on the machine. I do have ETH 0 and ETH 1 virtual network interface card. Interface ETH 0 for the NAT and interface ETH 1 for the private IP address of this machine. This is the private IP of this machine. List down the existing bridge information on this machine before Docker installation. At this moment, we don't have any bridge because we haven't installed or started Docker engine on this machine. Let's pull out routing information before Docker installation on this machine. You can see here ETH 0 interface is a default gateway for all outbound traffic from this host. Check out IP forwarding setting on this machine. Currently it is a disabled, which means that container will not be able to communicate with each other nor outside world. Leave this option by default. It is going to be enabled when you install Docker engine on the machine. Also check out the IP table rules for the Docker service. You can see at this moment there is no rules defined for Docker. So these are some basic checksum before Docker installation on the machine. Now I am going to install and start Docker service on this machine. I have installed and start Docker engine on this machine. Now check out IP forwarding setting on this machine. Remember, it was disabled before Docker engine installation. Yes, it is enabled now. Docker engine enabled IP forwarding setting in Linux kernel. Now all containers will able to communicate to outside world as well as each other. Let's list down bridge information or detail on this machine after Docker installation. You can see here bridge Docker 0 created. When you install and start Docker engine on Linux machine, a Linux bridge called Docker 0 is created on Docker host machine. Docker Bridge 0 will get a private IP address and a subnet from these IP address range. By default, Docker Bridge will get IP address from this IP range. Also, when you create a container, then Docker create a with pair. With pair in Docker is to connect a container network namespace back to the default network namespace. It does this by placing one of with pair on the Docker 0 bridge and other side in the Docker containers. List down all the IP address on the machine after Docker engine start. Now you can see one extra virtual network interface card attached on the machine called Docker 0, and it assigned a IP range from Docker engine. If you examine Docker 0 bridge, no interface attached yet because we haven't created containers yet on this machine. You can list down all the network that is currently associated to this Docker host, and these are bridge, host and none. You can read more about these network bridge on this article as I discuss in starting of this video. Docker create a separate namespace for each container, and Docker keep information about these namespace on this file location. Since we haven't created container yet, hence this file hasn't created yet. You can list down all namespace by using this command. It is empty one because no container yet. Let's look at routing table now. You can see here container has access to physical interface of the Docker host. Now let's create few container on this Docker machine. I am creating a container called C1 based on Alpine image. Let's create another one container. You can see here two container C1 and C2 is running on this machine. Now list down namespace detail on Docker network. Docker keep namespace information in this location. You can see here two namespace created for both the container. Let's use the command to list down namespace detail on this machine. Oh, it is throwing empty namespace. To make this command workable, you require to create a symbolic link of this file. Now try to run the command once again. Yes, you can see here two container with ID 0 and ID 1. Rerun this command, and now you can see two virtual interfaces or with has been attached to this Docker bridge. Check the IP address of container 1, and you can see here container 1 got the IP address 172.17.0.2. Similar, check out IP address of container 2. This container assigned IP address 172.17.0.3 from Docker 0 bridge. Let's check out
routing on the container one, Docker 0 bridge configured as a default gateway for these containers. This is the content of local host file in a container. Let's check out DNS name server configuration file on Docker host machine. Docker host machine using the name server of my ETH0 interface. Let's check out resolve.conf file on the container. C1 container also configured with the same name server of the host machine. Let's try to ping google.com from the container one. I am successfully able to reach out google.com from container one. I can reach out container two from container one via IP address. At this moment, everything looks great. I can able to reach out outside world. I can reach out another container on the same bridge. Docker use IP table to provide NAT network address transmission from the host IP to container IP and it vice versa. As you can see, we have a rule in post routing chain. Anything is coming from the source Docker 0 bridge is going behind host interface along with port. You can inspect any of the network. For example, suppose you want to inspect bridge network. So what you can do? You can inspect any of the network by using this command. It has so many information. Let me touch base only important information. In this bridge network, scope is local. In coming video, we are going to use overlay network. Then scope will be changed. But by now, scope is local for this network. Driver is bridge. This network implemented on bridge driver. This is the subnet information. All the containers that is going to attach to this network will get the IP address from this subnet. This is the container information that is hosted on this network. At this moment, there are two containers, C1 and C2. These are options and parameters for this network. This is the default network for this Docker host. It means that if you don't define explicitly network name during the container creation, all containers will create under this network. Mask enable by default. This will set or bind to all host interfaces. For example, if this machine has two interfaces with two private IP address, you can access any service in the container by using any of the IP address of the machine. And this is the name of this bridge network. You can extract any particular information from this network bridge. How? Let's see. For example, if you want to get the name of this bridge, you can run the query like this. This bridge name is Docker 0. Similar, you can get the subnet of this bridge like this. So this is the basic information about single host bridge networking. More videos in pipeline for the Docker's networking. Till now, thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.